Let's discuss the tachymeter function on wristwatches. In general, this function is closely related with the chronograph function. But before going forward, let me have a wrist check. This is the Saint Martin Year of the Dragon 2024. Beautiful watch. You already know it. It is on my YouTube channel. Okay, so let's continue. A tachymeter is a function in a watch that allows one to measure average speed of a moving vehicle or other moving object given that the distance is known. It is usually found in sport watches and is extremely useful to time races. As we can see, the tachymeter scale is marked mostly in multiples by 6, so the calculations must be done in base 6. And is valid from all times starting with second number 7 until second 60, or a full sweeping of the chronograph second hand across the dial. As a general rule, you must know the distance beforehand and use the watch to calculate or to compute the speed. For example, you can use it on the highway because every kilometer is marked by a sign or milestone on the side of the road. You only need to start the chronograph when the vehicle pass any kilometer mark and stop the chronograph when passing the next successive kilometer mark. The approximate average speed within the distance covered can be determined by observing the present stop position of the chronograph second hand and reading the outer bezel. For example, you stop the chronograph at second 51, passing the second kilometer mark, the second milestone, successive milestone. This translates in an average speed of, let's say, 70 km per hour or 70.5 to be precise. So your average speed on a highway is 70.5 km per hour. If you are located in a country that uses miles instead of kilometers, no worry, you only need to keep it to the same system of coordinates. So your speed will be in miles per hour instead of kilometers per hour. Also, keep in mind that some watches, like this one here, have bezel, like a diver's bezel, and tachymeter scale, so don't get confused between these two. Another example is using the chronograph on racing, when the race car you are interested in is passing between two well-known positions, I mean the distance between two marked points. Being a racetrack, the distance between two marks is well-known. For example, in a straight line on a circuit track, start the chronograph when the car passes the initial mark and stop it when the car exits or is passing the second mark. For example, you started the chronograph when the car entered the straight line in point A and you stop it when the car exits the straight line in point B. You read 140, that means 140 km per hour average speed between point A and B. If, for example, between point A and point B there are only 500 meters and you read 140, that means you need to multiply by 2, so the speed is 280 kilometers per hour. But let me give you another example. Let's suppose you are waiting at the airport to pick up your luggage and you observe that the conveyor belt is spitting out one luggage every 18 seconds. In this way, in 1 hour, 200 luggages, 200 suitcases will be on the conveyor belt. Let me give you one final example. Let's suppose we are at the Olympics watching the 100 meters race. So we know that the distance to be covered is, of course, 100 meters. We start the chronograph at the start of the race and we stop the chronograph when the first man or woman passing the finish line. And we will read around 9, 10, 11 seconds, depends how fast the racers are. So let's suppose the race lasted for 10 seconds. We will read on the tachymeter scale 350. That means 350 kilometers per hour, but it is impossible because these are people racing, sprinting, running. So we know that they covered 100 meters, so 1/10 of a kilometer. So we need to divide 350 by 10, and the average speed is 35 kilometers per hour. This is it with the tachymeter scale on the wristwatches. I hope you like the video. So consider subscribe and give a like. Thank you very much.